Hello and welcome to Devil's Advocate. How does the government defend itself against what many consider the gross mishandling of Anna Hazare? That's the key issue I shall explore today with the Law Minister, Salman Khurshid. Salman Khurshid, Pranab Mukherjee has already admitted that the government may have bungled. Most people go much stronger than that. They say this was a debacle, possibly a disaster. Can you this morning accept that the government made serious mistakes?
See, please don't pick words out of context. Pranab Da was speaking to the House, and in the House repartee, you want to
hang on a moment. Are you saying that outside the House he would say something else?
In House repartee, you have to call an end to issues that become irrelevant when you want to get to the core. And he wanted to go to the core, and he essentially was saying, let's not argue about your point of view. Let us now get to the
Salman,
core.
Salman, let me interrupt you and put this to you. Probably 90% of India today is convinced that your government seriously mishandled the Anna situation. Can you today, as an honest minister, accept that serious mistakes were made?
I'm saying that everything that you do doesn't necessarily give you those returns that you expect when you do it. You have to stand back and look at what steps you took, what by hindsight you might not have taken, but I don't think that this is a blame game or an acceptance of a
postmortem. Forgive me, you're sounding like Lehman Brothers claiming that subprime mortgages wasn't a crime. You've actually been negligent, you've allowed a crisis to develop, India has been traumatized for 13 days, and when asked, a member of the government hasn't got the capacity to say that his government made serious mistakes?
No, I don't believe he made serious mistakes. I do believe that it was a unique experience. I do believe it was important not just for us to act alone, but to get every big political party, the major political parties on board. And I think at the end of the day, that's what we achieved. And well, is the result
that
should matter.
What you achieved, in fact, was a monumental mess that lasted for 13 days, traumatizing India. But let's leave that aside. I'll come to that in a moment's time. Let me repeat my question. Are you saying to me that your government made no mistakes handling Anna Hazare?
I am saying that they made no mistakes. I am saying that the outcome of what
I'm interrupting
did,
you. Do you want to really say that? You made no mistakes?
Yes. Yes. I'm saying the outcome of what we did. It depends on what how you define a mistake. A mistake is to do something that you should not be doing. Now,
aren't you quibbling with words?
I'm not quibbling with words. I think this is a very sensitive, complicated and a difficult situation that is just unfolded into a good resolution.
Is this and pride? I think that is this bravado? Is this hubris that you cannot admit you made a mistake?
No, no. It's faith, it's confidence and belief that we don't want the government to be kicked around by people.
But the government was. The government was
government
not just
was
kicked
not.
Around. You
government
became a
not.
Football.
I don't think government was. I think it's the best possible resolution Parliament could have got. And if you look at what we have done, the manner in which we have done, I don't think you can quibble
with it. I want
to
give you one last opportunity to answer this question. I'm asking it perhaps for the fifth time.
Ask
Are you seriously saying you made
times.
No mistakes?
Ask me for 100 times. We made no mistakes. What we did may not have turned out to be as it would. Maybe our anticipation and calculation turned out to be not what we thought it would be, but I am not prepared to admit that we made mistakes. We very carefully, step by step, tried to understand a complicated situation, and the fact that what we did may not have given us positive results is not to be treated as you made a mistake.
All right, I let you answer that in full without interrupting you, because I thought it was fair that you should be able to explain to the people why you think you
know. That's only fair for the media to behave like that always.
Let's not quibble about that. Let's come
quibbling.
To the consequences.
I'm asserting. I'm not
let's
quibbling.
Let's come
I'm
to
asserting.
The consequences of what happened to begin with.
Sure.
Your government today, in the eyes of many Indians, stands discredited. Its authority is dented. Many people are losing faith in your government.
I don't think that's the impression we had first time after years, certainly in my life, to have a unanimous resolution by popular acclaim in the House, led by the leader of the House.
That acclaim in the House was not for the government. In fact, the truth is two of your most senior ministers, Kapil Sibal and P. Chidambaram, are discredited. Arvind Kejriwal refused to speak with them. At Ram Leela Maidan, they became hate figures.
I will question that. They were involved.
On what basis can you question
I will
it?
Tell you why. They were involved at a very difficult stage. They were involved when they had to take calls that were difficult calls. They were involved when there was intransigence on both sides. particularly
and
on the other side.
They messed up,
I'm
which
not,
is why Kejriwal refused to speak to
I'm
them,
not
which is
prepared.
Why they were withdrawn as interlocutors.
See, I don't want to,
you replaced
no,
them.
No, no, no. They were never withdrawn. Nobody
well,
was
withdrawn.
They
disappeared from
I'm
sight.
I'm sorry. They remained there constantly. They did what they were required to do, and they helped us all the way. I didn't go to the Ramlila ground. It was Mr.
Right.
Deshmukh who went
you
to
know,
the Ramlila
you
ground.
You may dispute that your colleagues were discredited. The country
not,
perhaps has
I'm
a
not
different
prepared
impression.
To share. You may be popular or unpopular with the crowds on a particular moment for a particular event, but I'm not prepared to accept that they are discredited.
All right, let's come to the impression of the Prime Minister. Today, many Indians are questioning his leadership. They believe that he wasn't in control during this crisis. Worst of all, in the eyes of many people, he's losing the respect he had in 2009. For the Prime Minister, this has been a serious debacle.
I don't think you have studied what happened, how every step was led by him, where how every decision was done by him. For 4 days, the Prime Minister just sat there almost as though he was in a control room, monitoring every step we took and every word that we spoke. And I'm sorry that if someone thinks that the Prime Minister was not in control, then they don't understand what happened.
All right, but the impression has gone across this country very widely that the government is discredited, people are losing trust, the Prime Minister's authority is diminished, people are losing faith in him. That's
not,
the problem
I'm
you
not,
face today.
I'm not prepared to accept that, but I certainly will say that the space that has been taken by contending people, we will need to get that space back. We do have a...
There's
we
an
have
awful
an
lot of space you've lost that you need
Doesn't
to get
matter.
Back.
This happens
an ocean has opened
happens,
between you and the people.
It happens in a democracy, and when oceans open, they also split to give you a path, as happened
You're
with
not Moses.
Moses.
You're not Moses. You have lost
well,
the capacity
not,
to lead the people
we,
to the future
not,
land. That's
not,
the problem.
We may not be Moses, but we are not against Gandhi either. Gandhi's on
you
our side.
You didn't fulfill his principles. The Gandhi mantle descended on Anna Hazare. You looked like the British colonialists and imperialists.
Well,
and
it.
Like them, you
that's
stand
your,
discredited.
That is your view, and I don't want to contradict it again and again, but I'm telling you, the bottom line is, whenever these kind of things happen, there are gives and takes, there are improvements and
okay.
And falling in popularity stakes. We know what we are doing. Know where we are going, and we know the time that we have.
Let's then come to the serious mistakes you made, which of course you say you didn't make at all, but the people widely believe you did, given that you knew from April that Anna Hazare intended to start a second fast unto death in August. Why did you not hold the special session you held yesterday, pass the resolution you passed yesterday earlier, so that you could prevent it?
We didn't hold a special session yesterday.
Well, you held a special day of debate.
We were.
Why didn't you do this earlier?
No. We were to do it for other legislation, but when we found that there was a criticality involved in the health of Anna Hazare, we assumed we could not wait till Monday.
How come you didn't realize and appreciate that the situation would become critical? You had warning from April. That's what I'm saying. Instead of understanding that this was a political crisis, you treated it as law and order. That's the error you made to begin with.
World over, why do peace talks happen when they happen?
Because a crisis develops, but you have to let a crisis develop.
Well,
is it right to let
no,
a crisis
you should
develop?
You should not have a crisis. Why do you go to a doctor when a crisis develops? Don't allow your
Isn't
crisis to
prevention
develop.
Prevention better than
of course
cure?
It
you
is.
Fail to prevent.
Of course prevention is better than cure, but you can't always prevent, and sometimes you have to cure.
No, hang on a moment. You had advance warning from April of a hunger strike and you couldn't prevent the crisis developing?
We did our best.
You didn't. This is what I'm saying. You treated it
it's
as law
assessment.
And order.
It's your assessment. We didn't treat it as a law and order problem. There are two parallel lines working. One was the line of negotiation. One was a line of trying to understand what was the give and take available. The other was the line which automatically has to be applied, which is a law and order line.
Hang on a second. You say there was a line of negotiation, and yet 48 hours before Anna Hazare's strike and hunger strike began, Manish Tiwari was calling him corrupt, saying he was corrupt from head to toe. At that point, you should have been reaching out. You were instead offending him and offending practically everyone in the country as well.
I think that we've talked about this in an earlier program. Manish Tiwari has drawn a line. It was a position that a young man took, upset by the fact that the Prime Minister had been had been sent a very distressing missive. He took that position, but he did realize that this was too tough
a position.
He realized
to take. 10 to 12 days later. It was a monumental mistake of judgment, and are you really blaming it on Manish rather than the officials of the Congress who authorized it?
I'm not blaming anyone. I'm just saying, I'm only explaining Manish's emotions. I'm not blaming him.
This is a strange explanation that a spokesman could make such a disastrous mistake as to offend the one man you want to try and win the confidence of.
There were many other contact points which were positive, which were creative and constructive, and I think that's what worked in the end.
Well, you say
please give us credit for what we have done yesterday instead of running us down on everything.
One can only give you credit for having virtually dug yourselves out of a grave with the help of others around you who didn't choose to become your burial partners. That's about the only thing I can give you credit for. Let me point out a second mistake. When Anna had announced that he wanted to protest, why did you impose undemocratic conditions restricting his protest? You forced him to bring people out in the street in defiance of your unfair and undemocratic restrictions. You created that protest.
You sound as though this is the first time the law of the land has been imposed. The law of the land is for everyone, not for... It's no different from me.
Not in this undemocratic, high-handed and arrogant fashion.
No, it was not in an arrogant fashion. I must pay tribute to the Delhi police and the manner in which the last 10 days have been handled. I think it's the most remarkable conduct and behavior, and I have this from Anna's side.
I'm very happy that you should pay tribute to the Delhi police, because I don't hold them and the country doesn't hold them responsible for the faults that happened. It's the politicians who are their masters, i.e. your government, that is at fault. Your second mistake was that on the 16th, before he had committed any fault, you swept down on his home and preventively detained him at 7 in the morning.
I can't understand.
It was offensive. It annoyed people across the country.
It may have annoyed, but I can't understand one thing. It's happened to me 6 times when I was UPCC president. You didn't ask anybody why that was done to me.
Because you're a politician.
Because I'm a small man. Because I'm a small man.
No,
and I don't
not
have
because
a, I don't have
small
media,
man.
And I don't have media partnership.
No, because this is an icon that had hundreds of thousands
this
of people
an,
behind
this
him.
Is, this
you
is
provoked
an,
those
this
people.
Is an icon
no one gets provoked when a Salman Khurshid is preventively detained.
I'm sorry they were. It's just that you don't know. Listen, I'm sorry. The world doesn't end with the media box. The world is much larger. The world certainly start and end with Anna Hazare. Anna Hazare is a very important icon. Anna Hazare is someone to whom our Prime Minister has not only saluted but paid tribute. Today, we are pleased and happy that he is in a hospital, that his health will be secure.
It's so interesting.
But we are not folding up and going away. Not because you think so. We are here and we will be
here. You're folding up or whether you're retreating because you've been pushed on the back foot and you're stumbling perhaps over the wicket, we leave that to the people to judge and decide.
Of course.
But let me pick
and
up
we,
on what
just
you
as
said.
We
you
will leave
him,
to the people.
You called him
sorry,
an icon.
Just as we will leave to the people to decide the role that you in the media are playing.
Absolutely. And it's only right that the people should have criticism if they believe it's the case of people like me. But
absolutely.
Let's come back to you because I'm questioning you. You say
I'm
you
questioning
treat,
you as
you
well.
Say you
I'm
treat,
not here just
you
to
say
answer.
You treat Anna as an icon. How come that a man who is considered not just by the people but by you as an icon of the fight against corruption when detained, and he hadn't even at that point been formally arrested, was actually put in Tihar jail alongside Kalmadi and Raja. That created so much offense, so much anguish, that perhaps a million people all over India in the next 10 days came out progressively in protest against you. Can't you accept today that was a terrible error of judgment?
Let me just tell you, it wasn't a million. It wasn't a million.
Altogether over 10 days, probably more.
You go on for another 6 months, it'll be even more. But now let's just get it.
Is it right that you should be derisive of the numbers that came out?
I'm not even talking about numbers. I'm just saying please don't exaggerate and please don't build an emotional picture.
But you're not answering my question.
Let's be scientific.
You're not answering my question. You're evading it, avoiding it.
Let us be scientific. If there was micromanagement, I would imagine that our colleagues, if at all they were involved, would have made alternative arrangements. If you're asking me, at the end of the day, did it look good cosmetically? My answer is no, it didn't. Maybe for the six
so
hours.
Are you
that
then
he was
accepting
detained,
in that euphemistic language that it was a mistake to
I've
send
said,
him to Tihar?
I have said to you, he was sent by the order of the magistrate.
Whoever's
Please
order
understand.
It was, you could have chosen
question,
to keep him somewhere
else. I
can't
question a judge in this country. I'm not going to be on your provocation questioning a judge on this country. But I have said to you, whatever may have happened, whatever we may have done, the consequences of that may not have been what we would have desired. I'm prepared to accept that. And if
that
I don't
is
accept
euphemism.
That.
What I blame, let me put this to you.
I don't know how many of your viewers are going to understand what euphemism means.
Well, let's assume the viewers do. Let's not question their intelligence.
I'm not questioning their intelligence. I'm questioning your vocabulary, not their intelligence.
I think they can follow the vocabulary and the word euphemism fairly adequately. What I'm saying to you is this: a progression of mistakes by your government from April till the 16th.
If I wanted to stay away from difficult questions, I wouldn't come to your program. Because I know your questions will be difficult, but please don't try to slip in the word mistake repeatedly by left or the right.
A series of decisions that many consider questionable, in short, that hundreds of thousands came out. You converted through your decisions a protest into a mass movement. You created the problem that lasted for 13 days and traumatized India. Today, with hindsight, I'm asking you with good grace, can you not accept that your decisions were wrong?
I said the consequences may not have been what we wanted them to be. If you want to use the word wrong, please use the word wrong. But certainly, I don't believe that everything that has happened in these days has been negative. I think some positive things have happened. We have gained something out of those positive things. I think for the future, we can say that this will add to our understanding and knowledge of mass movements of the kind that we get in the 21st century.
And God, what a lesson it's been. But let me put this to you. The country has been traumatized for 13 days. The country believes the government and senior ministers made serious mistakes. Will heads roll? Will anyone in your government accept responsibility for the trauma India has been put through?
Well, I'm prepared to accept if you think that somebody...
Are you offering your resignation on television?
I'm not offering my resignation. I'm accepting responsibility. This is the problem. I don't accept, and our government doesn't accept, and parliament doesn't accept, that you should be sitting on channels deciding how government should function. You can advise, you can comment, but please don't tell us how government
should
function.
I'm not telling you how government should function. I'm pointing out mistakes that the people believe you made, which you deny. I'm pointing out errors that led to a mass movement that could have been restrained at a protest. Again, you deny.
Error of judgment. Please understand. Now, let me give you words.
But what about my question? Will anyone accept responsibility and resign?
Please ask the Prime Minister. You're not going to ask me. Is the Prime Minister happy with my work? Is the Prime Minister happy with someone else's work? Is the Prime Minister happy with our collective? Contribution, the Prime Minister would be
able to. You know what that sounds like? If the Prime Minister sacks someone, so be it, but no minister will accept that he or she was responsible and honorably offer to resign.
I cannot speak for anybody. I can only speak for myself. You're not interviewing the cabinet, you're interviewing one minister, and I can only speak for myself. If errors of judgment have been made, errors of judgment are made whenever you are involved in a difficult situation. Errors of judgments are not mistakes. Please understand, I have a very clear
errors of judgment are mistakes. That's only a quibble to say they are
not. Quibble. Why would they have different words and different phrases if everything meant the same thing?
You know, Churchill said a lie can be called a terminological inexactitude. It is actually the same thing. Whether you call it an error of judgment or a mistake, it's the same thing.
I'm sorry.
One is a euphemism for the other.
I'm not prepared to accept
that. My last question.
Yeah.
The country has been through trauma. I've heard you defiantly refusing to accept you've made mistakes. No doubt you put up an extremely valiant defense of the government. Your colleagues in cabinet will be extremely pleased and happy. But for a moment, the people of India, wanting democratic accountability, might be deeply dismayed. They might say, he's a brave minister. He faced up to tough questioning, which perhaps his other colleagues are unprepared to do. But at the end of the day, when he was asked a simple question, can you accept you made a mistake? Pride and arrogance came before speaking the truth.
You use this word arrogance too often. I don't like it. I told you, courage of conviction last time. Courage of conviction it is. Faith in yourself. And we are not pushovers. We might have made errors of judgment. As I said, we may have lost ground somewhere, but we are determined to get that ground back. We have, I believe, reached out to a remarkable man in a remarkable movement, and we do want that movement to go forward and give India a much better scheme of things. We are determined it will happen.
Salman Khurshid, thank you very much for facing a hostile interview.
Thank you.